everyone and welcome back. In this video tutorial, we are going to look at another bracketing method that can be used to find out the root of a function. Unlike bisection method that we saw in the previous video tutorial, false position method locates the root by forming a straight line between the two points that represent the value of a function at its lower and the upper limit of the range. Therefore, the intersection of the straight line with the x-axis is the new estimate of the root. The formula that can be used to find out this root estimate is as shown on the screen, wherein xu is the value of the upper limit of the range, xl is the value of the lower limit of the range, f of xu is the value of the function at the upper limit, and f of xl is the value of the function at the lower limit. The calculated root estimate is stored in the variable xr. In the code, it will be termed as xm. So what false position method does is it checks if the function changes its sign in that subrange, and if a change of sign is found, then that particular subrange is divided into another two subranges with using the same formula, and the loop or the iterations keep on continuing until and unless the terminating condition is achieved. Now, the terminating condition can vary according to the user. Here in this code, I have used a variable which defines the accuracy, and if the function value at that estimated root turns out to be less than the accuracy that is predefined, the termination condition will be achieved and the loop will stop. So let's look at the MATLAB code that will help implement false position method. Now, I've already made a code for you guys. I'll explain to you what it is. This code accepts the function of which the roots will be calculated. It will accept the lower and the upper limit of the range and the accuracy with which the root has to be found. After the function inputs all these values, it will check if there is a sign change in that subrange. So that is checked by calculating the product of the function at the lower and the upper limit. If the product is negative, the sign change occurs. If the product is non-negative, then there is no sign change and we move on to the next subrange. So moving on with the code. So this is the formula that will store the value of the root. Now the variable that is used is xm. This is a simplified version of the formula that was shown to you on the screen before. After the value of xm is found, this while loop will run till the terminating condition is met. The loop will stop and we'll get the value of our root. So let's try simulating this. I'm going to use the same function that I use in bisection method. So this is that function. I'll give the lower limit, the upper limit, and the accuracy. And as you can see, the root is found to be 142.74, and all the values of the estimated root are represented, are printed on the screen. So this is how you implement false position method in MATLAB. If this video was helpful to you and you liked it, don't forget to hit the thumbs up button or subscribe to our channel. If you want us to keep making more of such videos, please leave your suggestions in the comment section down below and we'll try to make it happen. Thank you for watching this video. See you next time. Thank you.